never changes. And welcome to Gaming Pickers number 43! Yes, 43 and 28 games. Yeah, you might notice something I'm wearing. It's blue. It's a bit small, but it's blue. Fallout 4. 28 games today. I did have no gaming accessories, but unfortunately, or fortunately if you want to say something, I received something today. With this little piece of paper with the Fallout 4 in-game logo on the top. Dear fellow Fallout 4 dweller, congratulations on being part of the first 10,000 customers to pre-order the Pip-Boy edition. To show our thanks, please see the enclosed Vault-Tec t-shirt. We hope you'll be sporting this when receiving the game on release, and we hope you're as excited as we are towards enjoying Fallout 4. Thanks for choosing game. The game team, game.co.uk. Fallout 4! Yes, this is the free t-shirt you get when you're within the first 10,000 pre-orders of Fallout 4 Pip-Boy Edition. It even has 111 on the back, which is pretty flipping cool. So yeah, awesome. And may have another game pickups accessory next week, maybe, depending if that arrives, but I won't spoil it just yet. But yes, awesome. It is a bit small-like, but whatever. One size fits all, right? So yes, let's get to the games. We're a couple minutes in-ish. And we've got 28 games to go through. And it's really varied today. We've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12 systems, is it? No, crazy. So many systems, so many games. Let's get through them from the start, right? First, we're going to get all the little retro goodness out of the way first. First one being Top Gear Rally. Nothing overly amazing. It's just Top Gear Rally for the Nintendo 64. I got it on the real dirt cheap. I've been toning myself way down with these auctions because I've been stung a couple of times now, and I believe that was the calling point of me going to say, hey, sick of your shit, go away. So, yeah, Top Gear Rally for the Nintendo 64. Now, unfortunately, I've ordered more games from Sex. You know, yeah, as if I haven't learned from the first, like, five times I've ordered from Sex. So I've ordered more games from Sex, so they should arrive next week for next week's Game Pickles video. And also, I've ordered a couple of things on eBay, which should be here momentarily. So, we've got those to go with. So, the first one was Top Gear Rally for the Nintendo 64. It's just a racing game at the end of the day. Nothing amazing, really. It's just a crappy little racing game. Now this one, I was very happy to win. I won it for about £3, which is, as you guys know, should know, is absolutely fantastic considering what it is. It's Super Mario Bros. And Duck Hunt. I might be able to play Duck Hunt, depending on the light gun accessory for my Arcade Action 2 console, which uses NES controllers, I believe. It does come with a light gun accessory, which I'm fairly certain will work on the Super Retro Trio. So I might be able to play Duck Hunt. If not, I don't really care anyway, because I got this mostly for Super Mario Bros. Anyway. So I got two games in one, Super Mario Bros. And Duck Hunt. The arguably one of the best games on the system, which is awesome. So I finally own that, which is awesome. And slightly related, I also picked this up. I think I got it from China. I'm not too sure. I can't remember. But this comes with Super Mario Bros. On it as well. Again. Meh. But it also comes with Tetris and Nintendo World Cup. All on one cart. Which is pretty darn cool. Now, I got these around about the same time, and I got this for dirt cheap again. Something's screaming at me to saying that this is a bootleg. I don't know. Because I'm not a huge NES freak. I don't even call myself a collector because I have that. So those are all the games I have for the retro systems. That's it right there. Plus a couple here and there. But anyway, Super Mario Bros. And Tetris and Nintendo World Cup. That was one of my favorite games of all time on the Game Boy. And so was Tetris, which was like a launch title, wasn't it? So, yeah, pretty awesome stuff, those three games for the NES. Awesome. Now, the next system is the Sega Mega Drive. Or the Genesis. Which one's this one for? This one is for the Genesis. This is General Chaos. Unfortunately, I can't remember this, because this is one of those games that I ordered weeks ago. Months ago, even. This took a very, 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 very long time to arrive. Again, this is one of the things that stung me with all these auctions. So I genuinely can't tell you anything about it. All I know is it's called General Chaos. I'll do a quick Google of it, so I'll know exactly what it is. And when I play it, I'll know exactly what it is. But until then, gonna have to remain in the dark for now. So if you guys know about it, talk about it in the comments and tell me a little bit about it. Maybe you'll beat me to the Google. Maybe. Because I got things to do today. I've got a leaving due to go to and everything. And oh boy, party times. Again, another little Genesis game. This one's by GameTech. It's called The Humans. Now, I do remember this one. This one is like a little platformer, but I don't think it's got any music. Yeah, it's like a challenging little platformer. I think it's like a mix between like Lemmings. Yeah, because you have to control a certain amount of humans to get them to go from A to B, and they're like tribal. Which is really, really cool. So yeah, it's a pretty neat little game. It's called The Humans, and it'll work on the Super Retro Trio. Yeah, I love that system. This thing is probably my favorite thing ever. This one I won for a couple of quid, and it's a fully boxed copy of Alien 3 on the Sega Mega Drive. It even comes with the original manual, which always makes me happy. You guys know how much I love getting my manuals. I mean, it's not necessary for me to buy it. It just makes me more happier when I purchase it. The case is in very good condition. It closes perfectly and everything, and even still has the Sega sticker on the side of it, which is pretty darn cool. But yeah, Alien 3. Couldn't tell you much about it other than that it's a side-scroller, like all Mega Drive games, more or less. The Xenomorph, a fast spit acid, and are right behind you. Can't see very far behind. Can't see very far ahead in these air ducts. Hard to breathe. Facehuggers can be anywhere. Must find the mother alien. The closer you get, the more aliens you find. Better not have them find you first. Just keep telling yourself, this isn't really happening. It's only a game. Well, now you just destroyed the fourth wall. Alien 3 on the Sega Mega Drive. Pretty darn cool and awesome. Win. Next. Sony PlayStation. Now, there's a reason why I bought this. I bought this as a buy it now on eBay. And the reason why I did that is because I lost an auction for the Dreamcast version of this. And I wanted it so bad I was willing to get the inferior, quote-unquote, inferior PS1 version. It was like a little cheaper. But because I lost the auction, I was just like, ah, screw it. I'll just get the PS1 version. Total Vehicle Carnage in a galaxy far, far away. You just go around thwarting people's plans. Bang, bang. Boom, boom. Graphics is dated. Game and AI is dated. But hey, Star Wars Demolition for the Sony PlayStation 1. I really do wish I got it on Dreamcast instead, though. I didn't talk about it because I don't know much about it. Now, this one I picked up today. Because for the first time ever, I got out of work a little earlier, before all the shops closed. Because I always work until way after the shops have closed, and I don't have time to. That's why I've not done much game pickups this past week, and why it's been drastically lowered, because these are mostly orders, online orders, and that's the only primary way of getting it. But I did manage to get out today, after work, and, you know, get a few games. And this one was one of them. I can't even remember if I've got it or not. I didn't have my game list on me. Space Race. Miracle Space Race. All I know is that it's like a racing type game. Welcome to the Miracle Space Race. Somewhere deep in space, Hogan, Ahab, Cadmus, and their friends are all trying their best. I swear I've got that sounded familiar when I read that. Maybe. Maybe not. I'm not too sure. But I picked it up today for 50p, so I was just like, meh, okay, whatever. And it's on a compact disc. Really? Really? Just remember that in Miracle Space Race, anything goes. So yeah, here are some screenshots on the back, if it autofocuses. There we go. If you want to pause that and have a look. There's some more text if you want to read it, if you care enough. I personally don't. So, yeah, Space Race. Miracle Space Race. It's a racing game. Next. Dreamcast. Now, I got myself a lovely game called Soul Calibur. New release, $39.99. Lowest price guarantee. I disagree. I got this for a couple of quid in an online auction. The case is knackered, as with most Dreamcast and PlayStation 1 games, the case is pretty much always knackered, unless you're lucky. I'm not a big fan of the Dreamcast cases, but yeah, snapped there, so can't really do anything about that. But yeah, it comes with the manual too, I believe. Yep, there's the manual, so Soul Calibur manual. And it comes on a lovely Dreamcast disc. Of course it's on the bloody Dreamcast, of course it does. The biggest reason I got this game was, one, it was a fighting game, and I love Soul Calibur, but also that it's a bitch, well, not a bitch to emulate, but it looks like crap emulated, because the background all freaks the hell out a lot of the time. I don't know if there's a way to get rid of that yet, but hey, boom, Soul Calibur. It's a little fighting game on the Dreamcast. The original Soul Calibur, which is awesome. I can't remember if there was a, I think there was like a series before it, like before Soul Calibur, there was like, two names. Soul Blade, was it? Or was that in America? I don't know. There was like two names for it, and then they just brought Soul Calibur or something like that. I can't remember. It was a while ago. What's next? Virtua Fighter 3TB? 3T something. Oh, yeah, 3TB. It's not 3 terabytes, because it's lowercase TB. It's just another Virtua Fighter game. You guys know I like my Virtua Fighter. Virtua Fighter's fun. I always lose. The world-renowned AM2 and Sega bring you Virtua Fighter 3TB. All the thrills and excitement of an arcade sensation have been faithfully recreated on Dreamcast. And, of course, there's some screenshots in the back. Now, I'm fairly certain this one doesn't come with the manual. Nope, it does not. Of course it doesn't. That would be too helpful. So, yes, Virtua Fighter 3TB. There's some screenshots. Hey. Nope, doesn't want to. That's because it doesn't want to. But yep, that's the end of the retro games, you could say. Now this one I found for 50p today. I don't have no idea what it is. I just thought it looked cool. It's called Free Space 2. It comes in a CD case, and there is 3 discs inside. Apparently it's a gold edition, which includes extra missions not previously available in the original version. It's also by Interplay. That was the one thing that I noticed, because it was upside down. Oh, it was upside down like that. And all I saw was the Interplay logo. And immediately I was like, Interplay, you don't make music, you make games. So I was like, what are you? And it's some kind of like space game. It just shows explosions on the back and 3 screenshots. I checked inside, and all 3 discs are there. And they're in pretty good nick as well. Unfortunately, there's no manual. So I'm going to have to have a little look online and find out something about this. Because there's no requirements on here. So I don't even know what system it runs on. I'm assuming it's an older game. Because it says 1999 on it at the back. So, yeah, it's Free Space 2. If any of you guys know about the Free Space series, please, please, please tell me about it, because I am curious, because I just found it on Wim today for 50p. Next is a little sold-out PC game called Death Trap Dungeon. I got this because it was 5p from Sex. I believe this was part of the Sex. You know what I'm like with my Sex? Yeah, you can tell it was Sex, because it's got a Sex sticker on it. Apparently it's got bikini ladies on the back that are PS1 polygons, pretty much. I don't know much about it. The game just looked a little quirky. You run around slicing it. It's also got dinosaurs and lasers and swords. Sounds neat. But Death Trap Dungeon. A little cheap, nasty little game. Published by Sold Out Software. Of course. Another Sold Out. Now, I got this because I've always owned the expansion pack to it for some reason. Go figure. I have no idea how. I've owned it for over a decade. I just remember it being called Kohan 2. So here it is, Kohan 2, Kings of War. Got it for like 5-10p from Sex. And an online order, bulk buy, as always, because you know what I'm like. I ordered like £20 worth of games, and then they just ship them all out to me. It's always good. But yeah, as far as I was aware, this is like a strategy game. Build your armies, recruit your army from 6 distinct warring races and 5 rival political factions, streamline unit management, and handpick your heroes and warriors. I never got to play it because it was always an expansion pack, and I believe I got it from GameStation back in the day. I can't remember, it was like 10p. This one I don't know anything about, so let's find out together on the back. It's codenamed Silver, top secret project. You are Silver, a secret agent with a mysterious past. You have been hired by Autism, a group of politicians, scientists, who have got together to save the world from total... I'm bored now. Yet they show the main menu in the screenshot on the back. You have three screenshots and you show the main menu on the back. Seriously? And then in the second screenshot, there's someone talking in like a... I'll just show you. Right, that was the first I looked at, which is literally the main menu. The second one is... It looks like they're standing in the middle of an area and the lady's saying nothing. And that one doesn't really show much except for some controls. Next. Found this in Cash Converters today, 50p. I'm fairly certain I've already shown you it. As soon as I got home with it, I felt like I recognised it. But it's still in the cellophane. It's unopened. That means it's worth nothing because it's a shitty game. I think it's like Poundland worthy. Mars to Earth. Winguel is an alien from Mars that likes to have fun walking Mars. I've read that before. I don't know. Mars to Earth. PC. I don't get it. I don't get it either. Next. Hawks 2, because I already have Hawks 1. And it was a fun flying around game. And because... Wait, did I show that?
Yes, you did.
Did I?
Yep.
Did I?
Yep.
Just in case I didn't. I'm fairly certain I didn't. I'll check the last Gaming Pickups video in case I did. I'm fairly certain I didn't, but... Thrustmaster... I got... Right. If you saw it last time, you saw that I got this. Now, I don't know if I showed it last time, but hey, I'm showing it now. Yeah, Thrustmaster Flight Stick for the PS3 and PC. It is pretty flipping cool. I've played a whole bunch of flying games with it on PC. Runs like a dream. Also works on PS3. Now, I'm fairly certain I'm not showing it, but hey... Pretty cool, right? I bought it super cheap. That's why I got all these games from Sex. Memory. Right. This was also another reason why I bought it. So I could use it on my PS3 as well. Hawks 2. Now, I love playing Hawks. So I figured I'd get for Hawks 2 as well. For like, I think it was like £2 at Sex. It was ridiculously cheap. So boom, I got another flying game for PS3. Next. Yes. The next one I picked up today for £3. I bought it on a whim just because it was a PlayStation Move game and I don't have many as it is. It's crap. It's called Order Up! ! Right? That has to be there. That is part of the name. Even on Wikipedia. Even on the side. Those exclamation points there. It even says, Order Up! ! Is a delicious blend of fantastic kitchen cooking and restaurant empire building. That's pretty much all you're doing. You're just cooking meals. I imagine it's like those little flash games where they're like, I want this, 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 and this. And you're like, I'll make this, 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 and this. And then they give you money. And then you've got to do restaurants for it. Now, what's cool is it's one player and one to two players. So you can play with a friend as rivals or working together. So definitely look forward to playing that one. That's going to be interesting. I could have sworn I've already owned this one, but I just bought it on a whim today. £4, if I already own it, I'm taking it right back. I'm fairly certain I don't know. PlayStation Move again. Heavy Fire Shattered Spear. It's a first-person shooter for the PlayStation Move. That was... Meh. It seems okay. I mostly got it because it has a single player. Single player or cooperative mode for up to 4 players. 60-plus achievements, ranks, and upgrades. Compare scores via the leaderboard and 24 action-packed missions. Mm-hmm. Oh, it doesn't even have multiplayer. I thought it did. Nope, it's just got one player or one to four player co-op. Awesome. An explosive on-rail shooter that will have you gunning for more. Can't go wrong with on-rail shooters, because especially with like light gun peripherals such as the PlayStation Move with the little gun that I bought for it. Alrighty, so let's get through the 360 games. The first one is EDF 2017. You guys should know what this is. Earth Defense Force 2017. Got it from Sex for a few quid. I love myself some Earth Defense Force. It's like a really quirky little shooter game where aliens are always attacking you. I remember playing the retro version, which was pretty darn cool. and I just loved it ever since. So now I finally own 2017 on the Xbox 360. So Planet Earth is under attack from alien invaders again. An Earth Defense Force is the only chance for mankind's survival. Face off against giant ants, spiders, robots, and monsters. Always fun. It's probably a really bad game, but you have to suspend everything and just enjoy a game for what it is, a video game. That is how I've managed to enjoy all these games. That's how I've managed to do it, because I take games at face value, unless they're Kitchen Simulator. That is not a game. So yes, like the only gamey part of Kitchen Simulator I found was when I accidentally enabled a zombie shooter thing. You had a pistol and you started shooting zombies. And that lasted half a minute, if that. It's not a game. Next. Under Defeat HD Deluxe Edition. Don't know what's so deluxe about it, but you fly around in a helicopter. It's a shmup. It's a really, really, really good shmup. Really good. Under Defeat HD is a fantastic little shmup. It's called, you soar to the heavens, your blades of steel, and you shoot the hell out of people. Full game, all current DLC and patches, digital art book, soundtrack CD. Oh, now I guess that's the deluxe edition. Awesome! I love getting soundtracks. Soundtracks is fun. So, it's just a one player. It doesn't have two player or anything. And it's just a shmup. It's a really, really, really good shmup. And I think you can go, like, sideways and stuff. Like instead of, like, it going from, like, left to right, up and down, it, like, goes, like, diagonal and stuff. It's really, really good. And I think you can change which way you're turning as well. I can't remember. But I just remember it being a really, really good shmup that I really wanted, and I finally got it. This one I found today really cheap for a couple of quid. Samurai Warriors 2. I love myself some Samurai Warriors. What was it on the Xbox, was it? The original Xbox? I think it was the original Xbox. Samurai Warriors 2 is just probably more of the same on the 360. Follow the path of the Samurai Warriors through new tales in story, free, and survival. I think it's kind of meant to be like Dynasty Warriors, if I remember rightly. I really, really, really enjoyed it. Just playing as like samurais and flying around and killing so many people. It was awesome. 26 playable characters and 10 new warriors are ready for battle. Yeah. So yes, awesome. It's 1-4 player and co-op 2 player as well. Awesome. So Samurai Warriors 2 on the Xbox 360. Can't go wrong. Next is Kokoto Magic Circus from the Sex Order. Become sharpshooter. Use the Wii remote as a gun. 40 mini games and one more original than the next. Fun and surprising bonuses and malices. 4 game modes from 1-4 players. Arcade training. I ain't got a clue what this game is. It's just Kokoto Magic Circus. I didn't have it. Maybe it's good. Maybe it's not. I will show you the screenshot on the back. Next. It's still in the cellophane wrapping. It is completely unopened, and I got it for £1.50 off eBay. Parental discretion advised, even though it's a 12 game. It's got fluffy handcuffs on it. It's called We Dare, for the Wii. Flirty fun for all. Apparently they want 12-year-olds playing this. I don't get it. But whatever. these 40 flirtatious challenges will leave you wanting more. Use the Wii Remote in ways you've never imagined. We dare you to join the fun in this funny and flirty game full of sexy characters, daring minigames, and intentionally popular music hits such as Sex Bomb, Sex... No, don't hit me. Time of My Life, Lady Marmalade, and many more. Now are you ready to play? Hell yeah. It's probably the most harmless thing in the bloody universe. I mean, it's a 12, what do you expect? And it's on the Wii. But yeah, next, new, £15. No, it really wasn't. It was £3.99. This is Marines Modern Urban Combat. Cash in on Call of Duty much. It's like, I'm a first person shooter. And a computer to Louis Shepard. Yeah, you're on point. Lead a four-man Marine fire team through intense urban combat in this first-person shooter created with the help of more than 14 US Marines. Authentic, right? Authentic marine tactics. Tanks and gunships at your call, play co-op with a friend. One or two players. It's a first-person shooter. I don't know what else to expect from this, to be honest, but yep, that's the game in a nutshell. Definitely will be playing that one. Interesting. Next is Downforce, Speed, Danger, Adrenaline. It's a racing game on the PS2 that I didn't have, and it's got a lady on it. And that's it. Crash and burn, hold tight, force your way through, and head to head at 200 miles per hour. Probably not 200 FPS though, right? Now this one, I'm really happy to say, I finally own. Persona 3 F. This game is hard as shit to get hold of in the UK. Especially without paying excruciating prices. This is the NTSC version, which I can play thanks to MC Shark, is it? On the PS3? I can't remember, it's on a memory card. You put it in and you put a NTSC disc in and then you take it out and then you put the... I can't remember. But anyway, yes, Persona 3. The Persona series is an absolute fantastic series, but hard as shit to get hold of in the UK. Very entertaining, very fun, and I'm really, really happy to actually own this. The best RPG of 2007 gets even better with the definitive edition of Persona 3 on the PS2. I finally own it. The only ones you can get at a reasonable price is like Persona 3 on the PSP, I believe. Nah, I wanted a console version, so I picked this one up. I got it. Now, here's the clincher. Hold your buttocks. I got it for less than £10. I got it for less than £8. I got it for less than £7. I got it for less than £6. £5.42. I won a bidding at £5.42 for Persona 3 on the PlayStation 2. And that is one of the biggest highlights I've have, because it's just a really, really good game and extremely hard to get hold of in the UK, so I'm really happy to get hold of that one and add that to my collection and play the hell out of it. Yes! But I'm going to be playing this more. Just a little bit. I already own this one, so I'm going to go really quickly over it. Ninja Gaiden. Hard as fucking balls, but a really fun game. Hack and slash around, kill everybody. Only on Xbox. Ninja Gaiden. Really, really good game. Definitely recommend it if you have an Xbox. And the last one, I should have saved Persona to the last, but I wasn't thinking. I wanted to get through this quickly enough, and I don't want to waste too much of your time. Project Gotham Racing 2. It is just Project Gotham Racing on the original Xbox. And it doesn't even want to focus. Yeah, there you go, it does. Because I have a wheel for the Xbox. I have a wheel for the 360. I have a wheel for the PS3. I have a wheel for PS2, PS1. And I have a wheel for the Dreamcast. I have a wheel for the PC. I have a wheel for everything. I just need a wheel for everything else. So yes, that was that. I'm fairly certain I didn't talk about this last semester. I might be talking out of my ass, but I'm fairly certain I didn't talk about it in the last one. I think my girlfriend was just teasing me. But yeah, it's really, really good. Even if I did talk about it in the last one, absolutely fantastic controller. Still, I've been playing the hell out of this week. I think it arrived on Sunday. Or the Monday after the game, because I can't remember. But anyway, it is really, really, really good. This separates, by the way. I've not figured out how. I think I have to unscrew these two screws here, but it's really, really, really good. It's absolutely solid, and it works really well, and you can change the sensitivity on the bottom with this turning thing, which is absolutely fantastic. And it's got a little switch on the back to switch between PS3 and PC. You can't get better for less, and I believe it... I got it for like £7 as a discount clearance on Sex, but you can also get it for £10. So if you're looking for a cheap flight stick, grab it on Sex. It might still be a tenner now. So I'll see you guys next time anyway. There's going to be another Game Pickers video. I'm going to try and get some recording done tomorrow. I've got a day off tomorrow, and I've got a day off Tuesday and Wednesday as well. I finally got a couple of days off, so let's try and get some recording done, hey? Let's try. So anyway... Yeah, I'm stoked. I'm so stoked and pumped. Literally got, 31, 32 days until Fallout 4? Come on! I'll see you guys next time. Stay safe, survivors. And stay out of the radiation.